Let's get physical. It's Jordan here, back again with an update on all the physical releases coming to the Switch. We're in the third week of February, February 15th until the 19th, Monday to Friday. Retail, low print and imports, and our usual community spotlight where you show off your games and win a prize. Well, maybe. Let's begin with the retail releases. Azure Lane Crosswave is an interesting release from Idea Factory. I remember when it released in Japan, a lot of people were asking about a potential Western release, and here we are, shooting down enemy ships with anime girls in a mech suit. How can that possibly go wrong? Apparently this offers plenty of customization, and it's actually a remake of a mobile game using 3D cel-shaded graphics this time around. I mean, it's definitely something I would be up for reviewing if I had the time for it, but you know, we shall see. I'm not entirely sure about the availability in North America, but in Europe there's definitely an edition called the Commander's Calendar Edition, which of all things comes with a calendar. Who'da thunk it? Fallen Legion Revenants is the sequel to one of NIS America's earliest Switch games. This is an interesting RPG game. I can't say I'm a big fan of the artwork, but you know, with the publisher, you know you're getting something solid in terms of gameplay. This comes in a Vanguard edition, which comes with extra goodies, a mini art book, digital soundtrack, and inner artwork. This is Jonathan Rumors and God of Resin's Pick of the Week. Europe is getting a slightly belated release of ReZero and the two subtitles that are too long. This day one edition comes with a 4-pin set, which is always nice. Pins are cool. Another belated release in Europe is Iris Fall. North America got this last month and I haven't seen much about it in all honesty. I think we've seen it a couple of times in the spotlight, but no actual feedback on how the game is. It looks cool though. So yeah, this is releasing in Europe this week or maybe next week. I've seen different dates in different places. Anyways, Low Prince Knights and Bikes has been put up for pre-order by Limited Run. This is a fairly cool looking game. I really like the art style. It's a game that promises bike riding, friendship building, frisbee throwing, goose petting and treasure hunting adventure for one or two players. This is quite a highly rated game on the Switch, although, you know, from the visual style, this seemed more like a super rare game than Limited Run, but I guess they gotta get all the good stuff. Anyways, you can order this right now. It is worth noting that fangamer.com will be selling a non-limited version of this game later in the year. And this is Santa Tartaruga's Alisa and Boombox's Pick of the Week. To the Moon was put up for pre-order last week. This is a short, sweet RPG. I believe it was made using RPG Maker. This is a very highly rated game for its narrative rather than its gameplay. Great pixel art and music made this probably the best game to come out of RPG Maker, even though it lacks most of the elements of a proper RPG. If you want a great 4-hour story, then look no further than this. You can pre-order a standard edition now or a collector's edition, which includes a platy plush. Let's see what they did there. Poster, pins, soundtrack CD, keychain. And this is Alolan Jojo, Brent McLean, Ganicus's Pick of the Week. Super Rare have announced their latest title. This week it's the well-regarded Lonely Mountains Downhill. Juan reviewed this one when it released digitally, so I highly advise you check that out for more information. But basically, it's just you and your bike. Take it on a thrilling ride down an unspoiled mountain landscape, make your way through thick forests, narrow trails, and wild rivers. Race, jump, slide, and try not to crash. And if you don't crash, it can be quite a peaceful experience. Or you can even get some hardcore speedrunning going and compete with friends online. 5,000 copies available, and this is Alexander Kato's Pick of the Week. Alright, I'm going to include some Signature Edition versions, even though the standards will be available at retail. I know a lot of people ask me about these, so yeah. Firstly, a new game, Buildings Have Feelings Too. This is a personality-infused city management game, as you choose buildings and make them happy, I guess. Buildings walk around and talk to each other, and they all have their different needs. It looks like a wacky one. The Signature Edition is available for pre-order now and comes with a soundtrack CD, certificate, pins, and postcard. And our brand new executive producer, JCrod7776, chose this as his pick of the week. Yonder Cloud Catcher Chronicles is another from Signature Edition games that is up for pre-order this week. And no, you're not going nuts. Yes, they've already done this game before, way back in the day. This is the exact same game. I think it's even the same cartridge code, so probably no updates on it, which is a pity since the performance of the original game is really unfortunate, shall we say. This just has a new artwork, and the signature edition is in line with their new standard. They used to do them a little differently, I believe, back in the day. Anyways, performance aside, this is a lovely, peaceful game where you have an open world to explore and befriend creatures, help people out. It's kind of like Breath of the Wild, but without the combat. In the signature edition, you get a companion book, enamel pins, keychain, and arts card, and this is Dane Wilkinson's Pick of the Week. Alright, let's delve into the imports this week. Well, in all honesty, there's not much going on this week. But last week, I made an epic 50-minute video showing you all the Switch import exclusives with English. I did miss one, I missed Bayonetta 1. but yeah, anyways, if you haven't checked that out, then please do. I know no one ain't got 50 minutes to spare these days, even me. I made the damn video and I still don't have time to watch it. But I would appreciate it if you did watch it and watched it as long as possible, you know. It's the most comprehensive video out there on the subject. I put a lot of work into it, and since until February 28th, you can get free shipping from PlayAsia on orders over $100. Now is the best time to top up your collection, so you can watch that, see what takes your fancy, and maybe put in an order. Just remember to use our links in the description and the coupon code SwitchWatchTV to get a very, very nice 5% off your order also, and support us at the same time. It really means a lot to us, and we wouldn't be doing what we do without you guys and your amazing support. Yeah, so thank you, SwitchWatch TV, 5% off your order. This week, we only have The Silver 2425. It's releasing in Japan on the 18th. Sadly, there is no English for this double pack of visual novels. I think a lot of people want to play this due to Suda51 being involved in their original creation, but I wouldn't be surprised to see this make a Western release at some point down the line. I think it even got an ESRB rating somewhere, but I don't know about physically. Anyways, that's it. That's it for imports, I believe. Let's jump into the Let's Get Physical spotlight. Remember, if you're showed off in this series, then at the end of the month, you'll be in the chance of winning a physical Switch game. This month's prize is a European and Asian exclusive. It's Road to Guangdong, the road trip adventure. Why did I choose this one? Because it was cheap. Alright, eRockZ picked up this bunch of games recently, including one that's supposed to be out this week, Azure Lane Crosswaves. Also nice to see Creature in the Well being sent out from I Am 8-Bit. Not sure if they have any of those left in stock. Inactive Yeti, many thanks for using our code on some of these games. We featured three of these games in the massive video last week. Caladrius Blaze is a great shooter, and depending on where you get it from, comes with a nice metal sleeve. I believe PlayAsia does have those sleeves. Gavin is one of many to pick up Mario 3D World this week, along with a couple of other games. Executive producer Santa Tartaruga picked up a PC classic, now on the Switch. I was never a PC gamer back in the day, so I missed out on this one. I do wonder how well it adjusts to the Switch. René Boucher, sorry I can't do French stuff, sent in this game a whole bunch, oh maybe he's Belgian, sorry, a whole bunch of Final Fantasy, three of which they imported. I've seen a lot of people not like the Final Fantasy 9 artwork, and admittedly I wasn't a big fan at first, but it's really grown on me, I like it quite a lot now. Etienne picked up a classic game, Darkest Dungeon. This is the signature edition from Signature Games. Really great game, really great package. Jason Woodbury, I need to give you Dead or School, otherwise I'm keeping it for myself. Message me about it, dude. Anyways, like many of you out there, he got in Carrion, one from Limited Run, and one from Special Reserve. Aldemar Bernal didn't have a Switch game, but they recently picked up Pandora's Tower, which after randomly wishlisting years ago on PlayAsia, came into stock. And many thanks for using our code to buy it. I really want this game on the Switch. Come on, it's easy money, guys. Jumble Skull got in these games recently. Gunvolt Striker Pack isn't one seen too often. I think a lot of people were put off by the initial pricing when it released, but fine games are there. Cyan Wisp got in these. A bunch of games coming from Limited Run, including Mighty Gunvolt Burst, which I think is the first time we've seen it here. Perhaps it's just starting to get sent out. Jonathan picked up three games from B-Side Games in Japan. Kamiko, Brave Dungeon in the top right, and Kyogeki Quartet Fighters in the top left. That particular one does not have English, but it is a shooter, so it's not entirely needed, I would think. Cameron Duncan sent in these games, ReZero, looks like the Day 1 edition, which comes with a nice set of pins. Looking forward to that in Europe. Bruno Silva picked up these two, the often forgotten about Oninaki, which sometimes is considered hard to find depending on your region. Executive producer Brett McLean picked up Divinity Original Sin 2, which is a game I really, really, really want. I've seen it listed here in China, but I ain't paying like $70 for it, not in a million years. Executive producer Jay Cross 7776 was another to pick up 3D World, along with one of my favorite games of all time, Final Fantasy X. I love that game. Executive producer Alolan Jojo picked up these games, including the surprisingly hard to get Marchen Forest. Come on, Play Asia, get it back in stock. Loads of people wanted to buy this after my review, but they didn't have any left, aside from the slightly expensive collector's edition in Japan. Sky Racer picked up these games. Like, I tend to focus on Switch stuff, but come on, Skies of Arcadia is one of the best games of all time. Unquestionably, get it on the Switch, Sega. Ron picked up these games recently, entirely low print releases. I really wanted to pick up Gekido during one of Red Art Games' sales, but sadly, it sold out. YouTube member and legend in my heart, Joel Parker, picked up Mario 3D World. I am kind of jealous. I'll probably pick this up in a couple of years once my daughter is old enough to pick up a controller, and I'm sure we'll have a lot of fun with it. Professor Loney recently joined our Discord and wanted to show off their complete collection of Super Rare games. That is no mean feat. They've racked up quite a lot of releases over the years. It's impressive stuff. Captain Slow, hope you're doing well, my man. He picked up these recently, Little Nightmares, the TV edition, which is kind of cool. Check out Juan's review if you missed it. Also, my review of Citizens Unite, a really fun double pack of games. Check out my review, come on. Hayosha picked up these games, another one with Brave Dungeon from B-Side Games. I don't think this is the last we're going to see it this week either. Happy to see them get more attention. Zone 7 got this from Special Reserve. I believe this is the reprint version, maybe? Actually, I'm not sure. Once a game has a reprint or has like more than one version, I'm easily confused. It is beautiful though. Maybe it's Limited Run. I don't know. Little Guy Games got in these from Limited Run. Star Wars has been a really popular one. I even opened up my wallet and reluctantly gave Limited Run my money for it. JTIN was another one to get carry on, this time specifically the Special Reserve one. They do great packages, but I'm really not sure about the orange starfish. I've seen it a lot in pictures this week, and maybe it looks better in the flesh. I don't know. Chuck's Taylor's picked up the collector's edition of Gekido, which is an homage to the original GBA game. He also got in these games too. Art Phoenix of Sword has picked up these Pokemon games, including the DLC ones, which I think Nintendo kind of ballsed up since you have to download the updates even though the updates are on the cartridge. Kind of weird. Sab Deberin sent in these games. Darkest Dungeon does not photograph well. Captain Tsubasa, I really need to play that game. Kozai Hard sent in this photo, including their 150th Switch physical game. Final Fantasy IX, baby, what a one to have the 150. Also, got in the interesting looking Abyss of the Sacrifice, a visual novel import exclusive. Here's a bit of behind the scenes news, but myself and Marion, our resident visual novel expert, are taking a look and ranking all the visual novel import exclusives. So stay tuned for a video on that sometime next month. Marcio Quintanero, many thanks for using our links and code. Sorry about the customs fees. You have to be careful with that. I always prepay mine. Anyways, there are some great games in here. Moral Crystal Hate is a beaut. They got in the celebration box of Fate Extella, which I talked about last week. It is entirely my fault. You know, I'd save you a lot of money if I didn't bring this up. He also picked up two of the Simple series releases, very obscure imports with English. I won't mention their quality though. Ike was one to get the European edition of Hyper Light Drifter, which looks really beautiful indeed. Looks like a quality package, and North Americans should not have to wait too long for theirs. Jay Frosty also got in on the Final Fantasy action, showing off their mix of imports and European releases. Love it. Ed Mega Man X picked up these games recently, including Limited Run's collector's editions of Ease Origins, which looks satisfyingly chunky. Alright guys, let's have a quick roundup. Panzer Thief Zero, Marcos Blanco, Steven 665, Robin Hatherall, Lars, Adam Carasquillo, Pabs, Tyson Bailey, Susha, Invicta, Jazzy 95, Rovest, Ying, Peter Clark, Tim 10, Lucci, McLaren, Anime, Yusha, Cartoon Soren, Shadow 007, Chocoloco James, Raven Knight, I Like to Chew It, The One, Robert, Yarrow, Midnight Raven, and Geese Nuts. Always enjoy seeing what you guys pick up. Send me your pictures on Twitter over at SoWhatAboutGame. DM me so I can keep track of it, or you can tag me in a post and use the hashtag #LetsGetPhysical, and I'll give you a nice little retweet. Or you can email into us at contactus@switchwatch.co.uk. Just make sure you start the email title with Community Spotlight so don't miss that. Plus, we have a Discord, which is a nice way for us to have a chat with you guys. And you can send your pictures there in the submission section. Discord server is below. Please group all of your games together into one picture and send me just one picture, please. It helps me out with editing so very much. Unless you're doing an unboxing, then of course have multiple pictures. But, you know, try to keep it, you know, grounded. Right, guys, hope you enjoyed this episode of New Physical. Special thanks to our executive producers, Dane Wilkinson, God of Resin, Boombox, Brent McLean, Jonathan Rumor, Ganicus, Santa Tartaruga, Alolan Jojo, Alexander Kato, Elisa, and our brand new executive, JCrod7776. We have so many these days. And thank you to all the others who joined our other memberships. Please check out last week's episode in case you missed it, and the epic imports video. I would really appreciate it if you watched it, or at least tried to watch as much as possible of it. The longer you watch, the more YouTube likes us. So if you watch all 50 minutes of it, then you know what? I will give you a massive high five. The longer you watch, the more YouTube likes us. Anyways, yeah, here are some other stuff that we do. Bargains, physicals, of course. I'm on physicals right here. I don't know what I'm talking about. And of course, we have a brand new channel. Which we talk about PS5 and Xbox content. Links are here. Take care, guys. Have a good one.